Hello dear friends, thanks for watching my previous video. I'm your Manoj Patike. Today I have brought you next topic. We shall continue the topic. It's my second lecture on plant breeding. Let's get into it. History on plant breeding and history and development of plant breeding. Okay. History means in the ancient, from the ancient period we speak. In this, what happens is plant breeding has a many branches, like even we can say a domestication is an important thing, a selection, everything is a very important. In the domestication, why it is very important in the historical point of view means plant breeding, it has started with the domestication itself. Domestication means it's an artificial selection, we can say. You bring something, like for example, we can speak about dogs. Dogs in the initial days, they were wild. They brought to us and we domesticated those and we taught them how to be with us, how to react with the humans and how to feed them with our food, or how they should live with us and how they are important for us. We taught the dogs. Same thing in the plants also. In the initial days, some of the wild plants that were brought and that were taken care and they were management practices such that they will be adaptable in our conditions, or we learn how the plant grows and how to get a good yield. So domesticating is mainly that bringing a plant, either it is a wild or some other place, and planting here and maintaining the plant here and domesticating so that it will be helpful for us. That is domestication. That is the main activity that were done by our ancestors. Till now, it's a continuous process, because some of the crops are such that they will be grown in some other place. We'll bring that here. We'll make it adaptable to our place. We'll domesticate it to this place. That is, we say domestication is a very important activity that were done by our ancient ancestors that helped us a lot to develop this branch, and it's a continuous process. Okay, let's see one by one what our ancestors did. In the 700 BC, the Babylonians and Assyrians, first they, what they did is, they took a date palm, they artificially pollinated them. They took the knowledge of how to pollinate the things, or the how to pollinate the plants. They had the knowledge and they make a note on it. There is a literature about it. So it is the written thing that we know from our ancient days. So 700 BC, this, the plant breeding, one of the important historical activities started. And in the 17th century, till one complete 1000 years, we did not have any literature activities that are done in the point of view of plant breeding. But in the 17th century, in the France, what they did is a heading lettuce. They developed and adopted a heading lettuce. Heading means the leaves of that lettuce are in a rosette form. Such plants we call it as a heading lettuce, and they adopted, the France people adopted that. There is one literature document about it, and from 1717 we have many literatures that are speaking about breeding. In 1770, Thomas Fairchild, he is one of the important person. What he did is, he developed an artificial hybrid. First artificial hybrid with respect to carnation, it is called as a Fairchild's mule. It is called as Fairchild's mule, and it's a first artificial hybrid that was developed in the history, and we know the literature speaks about it in the carnation plants. Dear friends, I think you know about mule. It was a first breed that was developed by crossing two different species, like a male donkey that is crossed with a female horse. That is a mule, and it is called as Fairchild's mule because it's the first hybrid that were developed in plants, that is in carnation. So they just say it's his mule, that is Fairchild, Thomas Fairchild's mule. That's it. Okay friends, next important year is 1743. In the 1743, there was a first company in the branch of plant breeding was established, and the company name is Vilmorin. Vilmorin is not a scientist here. It's a company name that was started in 1743 by one of the couple who was a very good in a seed scientist. They started this company, and that's a first plant breeding company. Next is, in from the year 1760 to 1766, what happened is Sir Joseph Kohlrutter. Sir Joseph Kohlrutter, he made very much extensive crosses in tobacco. Extensive crosses in tobacco were done by him in this year. And next is, from the year 1759 to 1835, they are pretty long years, Sir Thomas Andrew Knight. Sir Thomas Andrew Knight, he artificially hybridized the plants and he developed many fruit varieties. He developed many fruit varieties, and it's very important in historical point of view. Sir Thomas Andrew Knight. And there is a person with name Lecoultier. He is a farmer, but his work was published in the year 1843. What he said is, the progenies that are obtained by single parent or single plant, it is more uniform. Yes, we know it's very common now, but at that time it's a very good and important work at that time. So it was published and had its own importance. It gained the attention of many scientists. Okay friends, next important is person Patrick Schreff. Sir Patrick Schreff, he is responsible because he practiced individual plant selection. He selected the plants individually, and those practices are done in those days, especially in cereals. He was working on cereals and he did the selections in cereals, and he concluded that the sources of variations are two, that is natural spores means mutation, and another is natural hybridization. These are main important sources of variation that was given by Patrick Schreff. And next work is Vilmorin in the year 1847. I think 1857, he has given this, that is Vilmorin's principles of progeny testing. Progeny testing, it was given by Vilmorin. Don't confuse with the company that were established, which is Vilmorin, and he is scientist Vilmorin, but he is a descendant of those parents. He is a descendant of them, but he is a scientist, he is not that of company, and he gave the principles of progeny testing. He worked on the plant sugar beet, beta vulgaris, sugar beet. Okay, next important person is Nelson A. Nelson A. in Sweden, with his co-worker, he refined few of things, that is single plant selection. He worked there on individual plant selection. He worked on, they refined some principles or theories of the single plant selection, and his work is also considered, it's very important. The very, very important work did was in 1903 by the Johansson. It is more frequently asked in many exams, in semester exams also, and in competitive also. In 1903, Johansson gave pure line selection. Oh, sorry friends, I forgot to tell you that the Vilmorin principles of progeny testing, what he gave was on sugar beet, but those principles did not work on wheat. I think you know about the self and cross pollinated crops, the importance of the selection among self and cross pollination took its attraction in this year, after the work of the Vilmorin. So it is very important, I forgot to tell in the beginning. Okay, let's come back to pure line selection. Pure line selection and the mechanism and the scientific ways of doing that was given by him. He gave a detailed info of that, and he worked on Fasciolus vulgaris. Fasciolus vulgaris, he worked on that. He gave the pure line selection. It is very important. Please try to remember at least this person, Sir Johansson's name. It's very important. Okay, friends. Shall continue. G.H. Shell, he was an American. He worked on hybrid maize. He worked on maize and the hybrid crops because it's a most cross-pollinated plant, and a hybrid is very important in it. And the works are still going. There are many genetic researches are done on maize. And he gave the detailed explanation of inbreeding in the plants. And it is very common, it's very important. The detailed effects of inbreeding. You know about the inbreeding depression and all. Those occur in cross-pollinated. Okay, that was work of G.S. Shell. And the person, the very great and Nobel laureate person, Norman Borlaug. In 1960, when you speak about a particular rice plant or something, we shall discuss that in detail. Now we shall just see what the important work done. That is, Norman Borlaug in 1960, what he done is, he observed a Norinten among the tall varieties. He observed there were one variety which is dwarf, that is Norinten variety. Please remember, dear friends, that is Norinten is not a gene. D.G. Wogen is not a gene. They are cultivars. They are cultivars, that is the varieties, few varieties. We don't say it variety because that are not commercially released. They were practiced by the farmers. So those are the cultivars at that time. He took that cultivar and he extracted the dwarfing gene and he induced and he grown or he bred the many dwarf plants. That is importantly Mexican dwarf. That is very important and very revolutionized evolution took place. You know about it. And such a Mexican dwarf were brought into India and worked here. And with, that is by the M.S. Swaminathan, sir. M.S. Swaminathan. And he released the varieties with the name Kalyan Sona and Sharbati Sonara, like other also there were. And these are very important work. And another is the in the rice, D.G. Wogen is a cultivar that were observed and from the Taiwan farmers and that were took and the IRRI, they took this one and they worked on it, and in 1965 they released the Wonder Rice. That revolutionized the rice cultivation, that is IR8. Thus friends, the breeding activity is still going on. Many works, so many varieties are released. Some variety become susceptible for some insects and all, and still it's a continuous process, it's going on working. And these are very important in historical point of view. When you come to certain plants or certain topics, we shall discuss some history about those things. We shall work on it. We shall learn few things. Dear friends, I'll tell you, we should not be intuition people now. We should be, it's the time to be intellectual. We should gather the information. I will work on it and I will be here bringing you more and more videos, more and more classes for you. Please stay tuned. Please wait for next video. Thank you.